Hello students, today I am going to explain you next topic, that is study or development of megasporangium. In my last video I have shown you that development of microsporangium, which is related to pollen grain development. Now I am going to explain you female reproductive organ, that is female reproductive organ as well as its various parts. So in that case I am going to start with the development of megasporangium. So let's start this video. In my previous video students, I have explained you about microsporangium and its various parts and how it develops. Now in this part, I am going to tell you about the megasporangium, development of megasporangium. So students, development of female gametophyte is our main topic, in which megasporangium will be developed, and then we will see the development of female gametophyte. First of all, megasporangium is a part of gynoecium. So you can see here two flowers, petunia and china rose. I have dissected these two flowers and shown in my previous video. You can see that video also. In that video, all transfer sections of ovary is also shown, and by cutting it was shown there. So you can go through with that video. Then students, dissected flowers are mostly presented like this, because in plus two these two flowers are very important, that petunia and china rose, and their dissection is also asked, and their different floral descriptions are very, very important. So next, you can see my dissection of flowering flowers shown in some videos, so you can go through with that one. Now I'm going to start with the development of female gametophyte. Students, this is an anatropous ovule which is called as megasporangium. So megasporangium is a you can say that represents mainly ovule, and this is an anatropous ovule, typical ovule. Most of the plants are having this type of ovule, but there are various different types are also there, that we will discuss in another video. Right now you just focus on anatropous ovule. So anatropous ovule, students, first of all you have to learn about its position. The lower side, wherever the micropyle is present, is called micropylar pole or micropylar end. So students, this micropylar end or micropylar pole, and where opposite to the micropylar pole there is a chalazal pole, and at the chalazal pole chalaza is present, that open space is there, and micropylar and micropyle is present. This micropyle is meant for the entry of pollen tube. So this pollen tube, whenever pollen tube will come, it will enter through the micropyle only. So students, after micropyle there is a presentation of egg apparatus and embryo sac. Embryo sac, egg apparatus and its parts we will discuss in another video. Today I want to show you about the outer features of the anatropous ovule. And then students, before this micropyle, just nearby the micropyle there is one structure that is called funicle. This funicle is stalk like structure with which the plant, the seed, the ovule is attached with the its fruit. And you can see there is a placenta, that is attachment of seed through placenta is called as, that stalk is called as funicle, and this funicle is supported by some strong rod like structure, and that is called raphe. And afterwards students, this ovule is having two integuments, outer integument and inner integument. The outer integument and inner integuments are helping in only protection. They are just for the protection of embryo sac, developing embryo sac. And students, there is an empty space over this area. You can see here empty space. This space is filled with some cells that is called nucellous cells. These nucellous cells are nourishing in nature. They provide nourishment to the developing embryo sac, and they just remain here for the nourishment of the embryo sac. And in embryo sac some parts are also shown here. Upper side there are three cells, that is called as antipodal cell, and in center two cells are there, that is two nuclei are there, that is polar nuclei, and egg nucleus is there, third nucleus and fourth part is your synergy. That is not shown here. I will explain you this embryo sac in detail in next video. Right now you just focus on the anatropous structure. One more part is there, students, this hilum. Hilum is a scar like structure. It can be seen on seeds, scar like structure, where from where the funicle is attached. If you want to see this hilum, you can see the kidney veins, that rajma veins, that you will, if you will see in the center, there is a white color part is there. That white color part is called as scar, and that is called as hilum, from where it is attached with the placenta. And the in between that hilum, you will see one pore like structure. Any gram, any peas, any peas, gram or rajma, kidney beans, you can pick up and you can see the micropyle. The pore, small pore is visible there, that is called as micropyle, and the scar is called as hilum. So students, by this method you can learn all the labelings and draw this structure 2-3 times by yourself, so that you can do the practice of drawing this structure within a time. And this structure is very, very important for the plus 2 examination, board examination. Most of the boards going to ask about this well-labeled diagram of anatropous ovule. So do the practice of this ovule. So next we are going to discuss how megasporangium is formed, that ovule how formed. So that is called megasporogenesis. This is the process is development of megasporangium from precursor cells or from beginner cells is called as megasporogenesis. So megasporogenesis will be start at bud stage. When the bud stage is there and our gynoecium is going to start, at that time gynoecium is having archisporial cell. Students, these archisporial cells are beginner cells, and they are deployed in nature, and they just go on multiplying. And after multiplying, these archisporial cells will convert into two types of cells, that is primary parietal cell or primary sporogenous cells. The primary parietal cell or primary sporogenous cell is also called as primary parietal cell will develop into a parietal tissue, which is a ground tissue and a space covering tissue. But this sporogenous cell is major cell, sporogenous cell. This is also called as megaspore mother cell, that is MMC. It is always deployed in nature, 2N, and this will undergo meiosis. When it will undergo meiosis, it will convert into 4 cells, and those 4 cells are called as tetrad of megaspores. 4 megaspores are formed, and they all are haploid, means single cell, because you know that in meiosis is a reductional division, it will reduce the chromosome number, and 4 cells will have a haploid type of chromosome number. So it is N. And now out of these, the 3 will disintegrate and 1 will develop into a megaspore. So students, this I will explain you right now. And afterwards, whatever is there, that is inside of the ovule. And as you have seen in our previous structure, that this embryo sac is, its arrangement is shown in this structure. And that is, first of all, the embryo sac, this megaspore will develop into mitotically, means mitosis will be done here, and that mitosis will give rise to 8 nucleus, and these 8 nucleus will be divided into 2 synergid cells plus 1 egg cell, which is going to the micropylar end, 1 diploid central cell, which is in the center, and 3rd antipodal cells, 3 antipodal cells are there at chalicellar end. This topic, students, we will discuss in next video with the diagram in detail. So now next one is how megasporogenesis took place, development of tetrad of megasporogenesis. So look at this. This, first of all, we have outer cells, which are called as new cells, and inner cell, single cell is there. This single cell is there, and this single cell is named as megaspore mother cell, that means MMC. This MMC will start meiosis, as I told you previously. It will do meiosis, and as I told you, this is always having a deployed in nature. They are this having a 2N, and then it will, meiosis will be done, and it will convert into 2 cells, that is called as megaspore dyad. And the out of these 2 cells, big one is towards the chalicellar end, and a smaller one is towards the micropylar end. The cell which is towards the micropylar end, that will be smaller in size. So this dyad will further divide into divide, and then that will convert into four cells. And out of these four cells, that is called as megaspore tetrad. Out of these four cells, the three cells towards the micropylar end, 1, 2, 3, they will degenerate. They will degenerate and provide nourishment to the developing one megaspore. This one megaspore, which is functional megaspore, this one megaspore will be functional and it will be going to give rise to ovule, and that is megasporangium, and then it will be form and further develop into embryo sac, and further development will be
tested. This is all about today's topic. I hope you all understood well, and students, do practice of all diagrams with labeling and thorough reading of your book. It will help you a lot. And in next video, I'll explain the case studies of pollination.